just know the time. Let's start when we hit the spot. Who do you mean away, but she only fly. With a drink, I got some now. Top D's tattoo, cause I'm rock and roll. Black, half white, down below. Gang of money, opened up.
Yeah, I'm running through these arms like Trino. I got that devilish flow. Rock and roll, no halo. We pull it up. Yeah, that's a movement. I'm rapping on a rise to the top. No wedding or Zeppelin.
Shuffling. Shuffling, shuffling.
Step up fast and be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad, now stop. Hate is bad. One more shot for us. Another one of these, fill up a cup. Throw this around me, just wanna see.
Oh, that's too hot to handle. Especially from backstage. Someone gets my humor. Okay, what did the skeleton say to the family after he served them dinner? Bon appetit, everybody. We're going to intermission.
Yes! Level 14.
Danny, how are you feeling?
Fine, Mom. Go! 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 No!
Okay. I think that's enough of that for now.
Why? Mom, just one more game. I was so close to winning.
Why don't you read a book or something?
That's the reason I stayed home from school. I am sick, but I'm not gonna read if I don't have to.
Fine. Just find something else to do other than PlayStation for a while.
Fine.
Danny, turn it off!
Why don't you read a book or something? The fight was epic. The infamous Jack against the evil King Garnet. Swords clashed together. And when all hope seemed lost for Jack, he managed to save one stout sword. He held her in his arms, and they looked into each other's eyes longest, and then leaned in for passion. Yes? Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair. I don't think so. years. grew up for sure, ready to cut you in thousands of pieces. They were the most fearful pirates. Waters became rough, and the boats swayed back and forth and back and forth, back and... Oh, I'm getting seasick already. Gift of friendship. This is stupid. I don't want to read. I'd much rather be my high school.
Danny, what would you like for lunch?
My PlayStation.
Well, you can try and eat it, but I'm not buying you a new one. No, really, what do you want for lunch?
I don't care.
So you're not eating lunch?
Whatever.
Okay then, call me when you're hungry.
Mom, please, can I have my PlayStation?
No. I think you can last a little longer without it.
No, I can't. There's nothing to do.
Use your imagination, Danny.
Once upon a time, no, there once was a dragon. Yeah, there once was a dragon who lived in a cave. He had children for breakfast and grown-ups for lunch. The dragon was so fierce that not even the bravest of heroes was able to slay him. But there had to be a way to kill him, because it was eating up all of the children, and their parents, too. One day, a young boy arrived. His name was Sir Dan. No, Lord Dan.
You can go back on your PlayStation now.
Mom, I'm busy right now.
Okay.
Where was I? Oh, yeah. Lord Danny comes to town and says that if it's slave, he will drive him. But nobody believed him, and all the townspeople laughed at him. So, Lord Danny had to prove himself. He walked up that mountain towards the cave where the dragons, and marched right in. When he got to the entrance to the cave, there was an evil troll. No, an evil wizard waiting there to cast him. You will never get past me, said the wizard, casting a spell on Lord Danny. But Lord Danny blocked the spell with the sword, and it ended up reflecting it back to the wizard. And the wizard disappeared. And Lord Danny walked right into the cave.
Danny, what are you doing in there?
Nothing, Mom. So many interruptions. Anyways, little Danny made his way through the dark cave until he reached the dragon. The dragon was big and scary, and Lord Danny was a little scared himself. But in order to prove himself to the village people he was brave, he had no choice but to slay the dragon. Lord Danny shouted, "You don't scare me!" And the dragon, "You don't scare me!" The dragon roared and stepped forward. Lord Danny stepped back, with one sword up and ready to attack. There was a battle. No. There was a heroic battle. Swerving and ducking. And just when it looked like Rodan was going to win, the dragon hit him and knocked him out. Dragon leaped forward to end Rodan. When all of a sudden, Rodan reached for his sword and plunged it into the dragon's gut, killing the dragon. Ah! Lord Danny had no tell to get this. He had slain the dragon when nobody thought he could. Saving the townspeople. Well, I think that was a pretty good story. I mean, sure, it had a happy ending. But there was no kissing.
Danny, time for your medicine.
Medicine.
Well, you need to take it in order for you to get better. Open up. Oh, you're getting a bit of a fever. You should sleep.
I'm tired.
Sleep will do you good. Oh. By the way, Dan, what were you doing in here?
I was using my imagination.
Oh.